Hi, Ben Constable with you from Spark Systems. Today I'm introducing the Enterprise Architect 14 Beta. The purpose of this presentation is to help you get started with the new beta program and get the most out of the version 14 release. So I'll begin by walking you through the steps that you take when first starting up the beta application. Then we'll consider the enhanced user experience in version 14, such as how to set your perspective and use one of the new model patterns to kickstart your project. We'll then take a brief tour of the enhanced user interface, particularly with regard to the refined ribbons and the streamlined context menus. And finally, I'm going to share with you some important product updates that we'll be releasing with version 14. So I have Enterprise Architect 14 Beta installed in my desktop environment here. So I'll just double click it to open it up. And you see at first you're prompted to choose an edition that you're going to use as you run the beta program. One thing you might notice is that the desktop edition has been retired as of version 14. But new in version 14 is this unified edition. And what that does is really bring together the features from the Business and Software Engineering Suite Edition and the Systems Engineering Suite Editions. So it brings those features together into what is really a feature-packed edition of Enterprise Architect. And I guess going forward, this could well become the go-to edition for the majority of our users. Professional, corporate, and ultimate editions are still available, so you can choose one of those to try the beta with. And if you're wanting to learn more about the release, you've got some handy links here to the EA 14 release page. And just below it, if you'd like to know more about the editions and how they compare to one another, you can click on that link. We'll just do that very briefly now. And you see, you've got a nice diagram that basically illustrates the difference between the four editions. So Ultimate is still there. That obviously provides support for the new data bridge. We'll talk about that a little bit later. The Unified Edition, as you can see, includes all the domain-specific support for enterprise architecture frameworks, some of the simulation capabilities and so forth. So bringing together those the features from the suite editions in earlier versions of Enterprise Architect. So you can have a look at that. The prices mentioned here are really just an indication, so there's nothing set in stone at this stage, but it does give you a good sense of how these editions compare to one another. So coming back to Enterprise Architect, let's just go ahead, and today I'm going to demonstrate the Unified Edition, so you get a good look at how that goes. When you first start Enterprise Architect, you get a really handy overview of the release. So this is just an excellent document, and it really shows this is a tremendous release in terms of the scope of what has changed. It's a handy place to get started because it shows you the major areas of change. As we just scroll through briefly for a moment, you can see about the new docked property window, and that is just excellent. It brings together all of the properties of elements, diagrams, relationships, and so forth. So the various kinds of properties that you can edit all listed out here. As we go further down the list, a tremendous feature in the new patterns and perspectives, how they work together. Something like 1,000 odd patterns that are built into Enterprise Architect now to help kickstart your modeling project. So even since we've last demonstrated that to you, more patterns have been added and filled out. We'll have a very brief look at that a little later on. Enhanced modeling and design, so about the user experience there, what we've done with workspace layouts to help you and streamline your modeling endeavors. Similarly with diagramming and helping you build up your visual model. An entirely new type of diagram, construction diagram listed there. So you can see we're only partway down the list, but it is a tremendous release. And this overview is a really good way just to give you a sense of what is available in the release. And there's no way we're going to be able to cover all of that in this session. That's why we're having a number of dedicated EA 14 release webinars starting since last year. Now, if you need to get the overview document back at any time because you close it down, simply from the Start ribbon under Help, it's the first menu item there. So it's a very handy reference point just to help you to learn more and really dig into the release. So we need to go ahead and create a new project. There's nothing particularly new in that aspect. If you're just creating a file-based project, I'm going to create an FEAP. Let's call it My Project and save that. The desktop will do for now. Now, apart from creating a new model and having a look at that overview document, what else would I recommend that you do when you're getting started with Enterprise Architect 14? Well, it really is to set your perspective. So what that does is tell Enterprise Architect what kinds of tasks, modeling tasks, you'll be interested in doing. So are you an enterprise architect, interested more in architectural frameworks, or a business analyst, and perhaps wanting to do process models and simulation, that kind of thing, requirements engineer, architect, etc.? Well, Enterprise Architect provides you a set of perspectives that help you define what kind of modeling tasks you're going to undertake. So for those that have seen our webinar sessions before, you will have had a bit of a look at this, and it really is the first basic step that I recommend you take in terms of getting into the bit release. So just from the portals window here is an excellent launch pad for the perspectives. You see the icon, click on perspective, and you see all the categories of perspectives, you know, whether it's basic UML diagramming we're wanting to do, we're going to use, say, business modeling, BP Sim. So let's just choose that perspective, and that, of course, invokes the model pattern wizard. Again, you may have seen this from earlier webinars, but again, it's been updated with even more patterns. So you've got, there's an interesting thing I want to show you, not just patterns that provide a skeleton that you can then flesh out, you know, kind of generic model patterns, that kind of thing, but also what we've called here case studies, or like worked examples. So rather than just getting some generic structure to fill out, if you want to see, for example, how a help desk phone support process might work, well, there is a case study that you can now look at and actually instantiate in your model. All the parameters will be set up for you. You know, for some of these, you might be able to do simulation, for example. So you can actually see a worked example rather than kind of starting one from scratch. And as you've seen perhaps in earlier webinars, just a tremendous variety of model patterns that mean you're not starting with a blank canvas. You know, you've got a pattern that you can take and customize for your own particular project. So let's go ahead and do that just to get started. I'll just click on a very simple pattern here, a BPMN2 starter process diagram. So I'm just going to create that in my model here, create the pattern. Okay, so it's already been instantiated. Just let's open that diagram up. I want to talk a little further on the user experience now, but with regard to the updated ribbons in version 14 and how we've streamlined the context menus. So when you consider the changes in these areas, the overarching goal is to make sure that we're putting the right tools at your fingertips for any given modeling task that you're undertaking. So consider first the ribbons, and you'll see the categories at the top of screen there. Most of these are similar to earlier versions, with the exception of the new specialized ribbon, and I'll talk about that in just a moment. It is important with the ribbons to understand the purpose of each one, and that'll give you a good idea of what functionality you can expect to find there. So if we go across to that EA14 overview document again, so from the help button there, EA14 overview, I'm going to search for the changes on ribbons. And here you see a really neat summary of each of the ribbons and just a little short description that tells you the goal, the purpose of that ribbon, if you like. So, for example, the start ribbon, which we've got open here at the moment, it's helping you to get into the model, to start exploring it, collaborating with team members and so forth. The design ribbon, that's really about building up, refining, editing your packages, your model elements, that kind of thing. The layout ribbon, basically all to do with laying out, building up your visual model, your diagrams. So aligning elements on the diagrams, formatting them, and so forth. There's a new ribbon, you'll notice the specialized ribbon, just open that briefly. So that includes what was formerly the extend menu, but it also provides some of those specialist tools in Enterprise Architect, for example, the database builder for all of our database engineers, schema composer, EA's scripting facilities, and new in version 14, the ability to integrate with external data sources. And so that's an entirely new feature. It deserves really an entire webinar. So we're not going to be able to go through that new feature in this session, but you know it's there. You're able to start exploring that for yourself, and we'll be presenting on that topic, no doubt, in the near future. So there's just a few examples, but I really want you to be able to explore the ribbons and the changes in that regard further on your own. So this is one useful resource, the EA 14 overview there. But another good one, just remember the portals. This is just an excellent launch pad into various aspects of the modeling environment. So you've got the guidebook and the learning resources here. So if I click on the guidebook, what that does is invokes a list of really useful PDF documents, basically whether they are tutorials or an exhaustive list, basically, of the ribbons and a description of their contents. So you can, if you need a document form of help to get going, you've got that by way of the guidebooks that we provide there. If you need something more like HTML or web-based learning resources, you click on the learning portal there. And again, the third menu item down, you can see there's an entry specifically for ribbons. So I want you to be able to go and dig into this aspect of the new release for yourself and find out more. So you can just simply click one of those learning resources, and that'll bring up a detailed topic for you. A general description first, of course, of the ribbons and how they work in EA, and then under the topics here is listed each and every ribbon and their contents. So just a really good way to dig in a little bit further than what we're able to do in this very brief session. So I want to focus now on the changes to the context menus. As I mentioned, these have been simplified and streamlined, and they're really all about helping you to build up your visual model. So let's look first at the diagram context menu. So if I just right-click on the diagram background here, brings up the diagram context menu. And you might think at first, oh, this is somewhat condensed compared to the previous versions of Enterprise Architect, but it certainly does not contain less functionality. When you combine with what's available in the ribbons, there's in fact more in version 14 by a long way. But what we've done to help simplify the context menus, firstly, we've grouped and moved some of the common items into submenus. So for example, the insert menu here, rather than having these enumerated out at the top level, whether you're inserting a new element, a document into the model, or you want to insert a new element by way of the toolbox, that's neatly grouped for you in the insert item of the context menu. Similarly with the paste operations, it's just been neatly, sensibly grouped to make this to make the context menu more approachable, remembering that EA has a vast feature set. So we're just making sure that no matter which modeling domain you're coming from, you're able to approach the functionality, and in this case by way of the context menu. So some of the items that don't directly relate to building up your visual model have been moved into an appropriate ribbon. So there was an advanced menu before. Well, that functionality, of course, is now available in the layout ribbon. So remembering that the layout ribbon is really about your diagramming, all of those more advanced operations, the things that you're not doing day to day, are available via that ribbon. So under manage, you've got the ability to add the current diagram to your working set, compare to a baseline, save as a profile, those kind of features, and of course a whole lot more. So let's have a look briefly at the element context menu. So right click on the activity here, and again you see a real logical grouping of the context menu items. So take one example, features and properties. There also used to be a separate structural elements menu item at the top level there. Well, now all that's nicely grouped together for us. So attributes, operations, and the structural elements are available there as interaction points, as they are correctly labeled. Now, just remember that all of these context menu items are available from the corresponding ribbon. So in the case of elements in the design ribbon, we can choose or select any given element and then go under element features. That'll bring up the features docking view, which has basically editors for all of those element features, including the interaction points. So just right click and add new and so forth. Finally, let's consider the project browser context menu, which has also been simplified to strongly focus on building models. So you'll see a number of the items relate to adding to the model, such as a new pattern, package, diagram, and so forth, whereas other context menu items have been moved out, such as the up-down arrows. You see them available from the project browser toolbar, others from the project browser's own menu. And of course, all of the functionality is available from the appropriate ribbon. So to give a couple of other examples where you may have been used to generating documentation or even code by right-clicking a package in the project browser, you can access that functionality from the appropriate ribbon. So in the case of documentation, we simply go to Publish, Documentation, and away you go. So you've got the project browser to select your package, and then use the ribbon from there. Similarly with code, if we had classes or something like this we're generating, just select the package in the project browser, code, and generate, and you're away. So again, the focus of this is really to help make sure that you've got the tools that you're using often, especially to build up the model available in the context menu items there. The ribbons really neatly capture the entirety of EA's feature set, and I found it a really useful way to work with the vast array of tools that you actually need within a modeling environment. I want to briefly review some of the product updates that I mentioned in this presentation. As noted, there's an entirely new edition of Enterprise Architect, the Unified Edition, and that represents a tremendous breadth of modeling domains and activities. Included in that would be business process, simulation, execution of software systems, and so on. So it really is a feature-packed edition of Enterprise Architect. With the Unified Edition coming in, we're retiring the desktop edition, but ramping up the professional edition, which will now support floating licenses and the ability to connect to cloud-based models. That is, those that don't have role-based security enabled, because that's a specific feature of corporate edition and above. I'd like to briefly review some of the steps that I recommended when getting into the beta program. Of course, first, you need to download the installer if you haven't already done so. Get that from sparksystems.com/EA14, just available to registered users at this stage. You can then install and run the version 14 beta in the usual way, though we do recommend using a non-production environment for that. As you saw, when you start up the program, you'll have the ability to compare the available editions and then choose one of those to use. And after creating a new model, I certainly recommend you explore the perspectives and the various patterns that are associated with that to help give you a kickstart to your modeling project. And there's a real array of learning resources that we've put in place to help familiarize you with the version 14 release. I'll show you those in just a moment. Any feedback that you've got, issues or comments on the beta release, we welcome your feedback at 14beta@sparksystems.com. So some of those learning resources that we pointed out, there are, of course, all of our previous webinars on Enterprise Architect version 14. So some of those went into very specific features. This presentation on the beta will be available shortly. If you want a summary of all that's updated and new in version 14, have a look at our release page, sparksystems.com/EA14. And within the program itself, remember you've got the portals there as a real launch pad. You can use the guidebook or the learning buttons there to get document-based help or web-based help as well. And you've got the EA14 overview document that you see on startup, and it's also available from the start ribbon if you use the help button. So that's it from me today. Until next time, happy modeling.